Hello my dear students, in this video session we will learn about a position time graph, different position time graph under motion in a straight line chart. So we can easily understand the motion of an object by observing the graph. So we have to see the graphical representation of motion. So we can easy to represent the motion of an object in a graph. I hope we already discussed about that positions and frame of reference and all. We have a frame of reference, idea of frame of reference. The frame of reference means set of axis along with a time. X-axis, y-axis, z-axis means the rectangular coordinate systems along with the time is that, means that we will call it as a frame of reference. So based on that, graphically we have to see how to represent the motion of an object. So different types of motion of an object. First of all, let us see about the position time graph. So position will be represented by x and time will be represented by t. So x is in measured in meter, time is measured in second. So we can also call it as an xt graph. Position time graph or xt graph, the position and time graph. So let us see the different motion of an object. The first one, if it is object is at rest, then how will you represent that motion of an object? Next, object is moving at some velocity or in a uniform motion, then how to represent the graph? And object is in a non-uniform motion, then how to represent the graph? Let us see one by one. Before that, if I ask for a definition, what is position time graph means? The position time graph can be defined as, it's a graph, particularly a position is taken in an y-axis and time is taken in an x-axis. The graph was plotted between position and time, just like this. Graph was plotted between position and time. In position is taken in an y-axis, position is taken in an y-axis, that is represented in an y-axis, and time is represented in an x-axis. The time is represented in an x-axis. So we have a rectangular coordinate system x and y. Along the y-axis position, along the x-axis time. So this will be the position time graph. Particularly we have to see the object is at rest. Object is at rest. How to represent a curve for an object at rest? So somewhat how object is rest at 50 meter. At 50 meter, object is at rest. With respect to time, that position is same, does not change. Then we can say that object is at rest. The curve is a straight line which is parallel to the time axis. Curve is a straight line which is parallel to time axis. I hope this is understood. The object is at rest. In fact, this will be the representation of position time graph. For an object is at rest, the curve is which is parallel to the time axis. Next, the second one is just like the same thing, along x-axis time, along y-axis the position vertex, and object is start from the origin, that means the initial, usually origin is taken as an initial point. So uniform motion, a uniform motion, uniform motion, object is under uniform motion. We already know the definition of uniform motion. An object covers equal distance with equal intervals of time. That one will represent like this. Equal distance. Equal distance. Just like 10 meter in 10 seconds. Next 10 meter, next 10 seconds. So the curve is a linear curve itself. It's a straight line itself. But it is inclined, straight line, which is passing through the origin, passing through that origin, which is inclined straight line. That is inclined straight line. We'll call it as an inclined straight line, and which is passing through the origin. So this is the graphical representation of uniform motion, particularly and a position time graph. And we have a to represent another one, a non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. Object is under non-uniform motion. Any object is under non-uniform motion. This representation is important. X-axis and y-axis representations are very important, and origin also is very important. And here, non-uniform motion. We have an idea about non-uniform motion. What is non-uniform motion? An object covers equal distance in unequal intervals of time. So that means which is not a straight line. That's it. Which is not a straight line. So like this also you can represent. So that will be the non-uniform motion, which is start from the origin. Okay. So this is about a graphical representation, particularly position time graph. Graphical representation of motion of an object. Different cases. The first one at rest, next uniform motion, next non-uniform motion. And I'll come to this point, the uniform motion. In this, here I started from the origin, right? So this is object is start from its origin, uniform motion. Sometimes object is not start from its origin. Object will be at some other position. So we can also draw like this. If an object start from some other position, 40 meter, it start from 40 meter and it is covers equal distance in equal intervals of time later with a constant velocity, uniform motion, the 40 meter. That is, object is not start from the origin or an initial point. Somewhat will start from that 40 meter. So these are the different types of motion represented in position time graph. So we'll see the next things, the different other types, just like a positive velocity, negative velocity and zero velocity things, and also positive acceleration, negative acceleration, zero acceleration. Okay.